So today I'm going to explain your 10th standard biology. First up, biology 14 chapter, that is ecosystem part 1 video. So let's come to the chapter. So ecosystem, as you know, ecosystem is the interaction of living things among themselves and with the surrounding environment. So there are two types of ecosystem, that is terrestrial and aquatic. So structure of ecosystem. So the interaction between the various biotic and aquatic factors of an ecosystem is the maintenance of the ecosystem. And also stratification is the vertical distribution of different species occupying the different levels. For example, stress occur at a higher level than the shear ups like that. The various aspects taken into consideration to study the function of ecosystem are: first is the productivity, next is the decomposition, next is the energy flow, next is the nutrient cycle. So the cycling, these are the different levels. So first let's come to the productivity. So if productivity supply of sunlight is required for the proper function of an ecosystem, the sunlight is very much important, and the amount of biogas produced per unit area for a time period by plants during the time of photosynthesis is called as the primary productivity, and it is expressed as weight g minus 2 or energy cal m minus 2. Next is secondary productivity. So next is the secondary productivity, that is defined as the rate of formation of new organic matter by consumers is called as the secondary productivity. And primary productivity depends on the types of plant species that is in that particular area, and photosynthesis capacity of the plant, nutrient availability, and annual net productivity for whole biosphere is about 170 tons of organic matter. So these are the factors that depends on for the primary productivity. Next, decomposers. So it is the process of breaking down of complex organic matter into the inorganic substance like carbon dioxide, water, nutrients, etc. In that fragmentation, what is fragmentation? Is breaking down of detrites, dead plants and animals into smaller particles by decomposers. Next is leaching, process by which these inorganic matter enter the soil. These inorganic matter or the decomposers enter the inorganic matter means the body, dead plants and animals that enter the soil. Next is the catabolism, process by which the detritus is degrading into simpler inorganic substance by bacteria or fungi. Next is humification, accumulation of humus in the soil. So accumulation of humus in the soil. Mineralization, process by which humus further degrades to release minerals into the soil. So humus further degrades to release the minerals into the soil. Next is energy flow. So sun is the sole source of energy for all the ecosystem of the earth. So plants and other photosynthetic organisms utilize 50% of the solar radiation, that is called as the photosynthetic active radiation, PAR. And in the ecosystem, plants are called the producer, and all animals depends upon the plants for food. They are called as the consumers and are heterotrophs. And the consumers are further divided into primary consumers, that is herbivorous, secondary consumers, that is the primary carnivorous, territory consumers, that is the secondary carnivorous. Next, what is food chain? The energy flow among the various constituents animals is called as the food chain. So this is known as food chain. Next is food web. The interaction of various food chain is called as the food web. And tropical level, every organism occupies a specific level in their food chain known as the tropical level. Next is standing crop. each tropical level contains a certain amount of living material at a certain time that are known as living material, like certain amount of food it contains. So the number of tropical levels in a food chain is restricted, since the energy transfer follows to 10%. 10% of energy is transferred from a lower tropical level to a higher one. So this much of energy is passed from lower to higher level. Next, ecological pyramid. So the energy relationship between the different tropical level is represented by the ecological pyramids. So their base presents the producers and the first tropical level, while and the other top level consumers. Next is ecological pyramids are of three types: pyramid of number, pyramid of biomass, pyramid of energy. These are the three types. See here, the pyramid of number. See here, pyramid of biomass, mass, dry weight. Pyramid of sunlight, 10 joules, 100 joules, 1000 joules, 10,000 joules, like that only. Means it will get decreased. 10,000 joules, 1000 joules, 100 joules, 10 joules for prime territory consumers. Like that only. In ecosystem, there are three pyramid or upright, except in some cases. The pyramid of biomass is inverted in an ocean ecosystem, so there are inverted, not correct. And the pyramid of number can be inverted when say a large tree is eaten by a small insect. So the pyramid of number can be sometimes inverted, because when when a large tree is eaten by some small insects, then it will be inverted. The pyramid of energy is always upright. They are upright. So limitations of ecosystem ecological pyramids. So the ecological pyramid do not take into account the same species belonging to more than one tropical. So same species, they take only same species belonging to more than one tropical level. They do not take. So the if a species is belonging to primary and secondary consumer also, they will not take it. They will not consider it. That ecosystem will not consider it. And next is, it assumes a simple food chain that almost never exists in nature. It does not explain food webs. So it says only simple food chain, but it does not consist in nature, and it does not explain about food web at all. It explains about only simple food chain. A saprophytes are not given a place in ecological pyramids. They are not given a place. But even though they play a vital role in the ecosystem. So okay friends, this was your chapter, the ecosystem. So I think you understand all the topics still here about the food chain, food web, ecosystem, and the three types of ecosystem: the biomass, primary ecosystem, and other ecosystem. You have understood, I think so. So okay friends, like the video, comment on the video, and subscribe my channel and my coaching center for more video. I will explain the next topic of your chapter, ecosystem, in my next video. Till then, take care, have a nice day. Bye, see you my dear friends.